Well, that was exhausting. So. Good evening. We actually have people here tonight who made that journey. Our team from the UK, led by Brian Bell. We also have Canada in the house tonight. But some of us now think Grant is the actual Canadian representative, quite frankly. I just want to start by thanking the folks here at Cipriani's. What a great job they do, year after year, work with us leading up to tonight. Thank you guys so much, the servers, folks behind the scenes. Of course, I want to thank Lori, Ari, Stephen, the entire engagement team for making this just another great event. Brian from LDI, I sometimes forget he's not one of our staff. He's here dedicating himself, printed our materials for us for free. He's working side by side with our staff. Very appreciative. It's really a privilege to be part of a growing team. 4,000 strong, working across the UK, Canada, 22 states in the US, with a common mission: economic well-being for all through high-quality education, workforce and economic development, and occupational health. I want to thank all of you for joining us tonight. The theme for tonight, Gala, is Impact Amplified. Now that's the power of possible. In addition to the, might I say, fully vaccinated hundreds of people in this room, over 500 people have joined us virtually. There really are too many people at an event like this to single folks out, but I do want to say a special hello and a special thank you to Bill Kahn and his wife, Vinny. She goes by Vinny. Last year, in the midst of COVID, we combined with APEX, a New York City trade school, founded over 60 years ago by Bill's father, John Kahn, the chief. Since then, APEX has graduated over 40,000 people, plumbers, electricians, and other trades. APEX changed their lives in ways we can't imagine. And under the leadership of Steve Markowitz, who has been with APEX almost 40 of those years, we have begun an expansion. We hope to make Bill and his family proud with the work that will continue over the next 60 years. John Kahn, by the way, was nicknamed the Chief because he served in World War II as a chief engineer in the Navy. So thank you, Bill, and thanks to the foundation you and your family poured. APEX will change the lives of another 40,000 people. I also want to introduce a very important strategic partnership with Paul Smith's College. Founded in 1946, Paul Smith's College serves approximately 1,000 students a year, and over 46% are the first in their families to attend college. We'll hear more about Paul Smith's history and why it matters in the coming months, but with us tonight virtually is the chairman of the board, Mark Dwanzik, and in person tonight, the president of the college, Scott Dalrymple. Welcome. And we are very, very excited about our combined future. This night is very special for the Fedcap Group. It provides us with an opportunity to thank our thousands of partners, donors, funders, to applaud the extraordinary success of those we serve, those seeking a better life for themselves and also their children. It's also an opportunity to honor the hard work of our board and staff, and to remember those who left us. At our last live gala in 2019, I shared that I was filled with excitement about what was next, what we could get done in the next year and over the next many years. I don't think anyone could have imagined what would be next. And in fact, 3 months later, the entire world changed. Thanks to all of you in this room, our board, led by our chairman, Mark O'Donohue, staff, donors, key partners, we did make it through COVID. Our staff performed in top-tier form. Many in this room, and even more virtually, they took a deep breath, and like many, jumped into the unknown. We emerged at the other end, stronger, smarter, and here tonight, now, again, filled with excitement about what is next. The late Colin Powell said, "A dream doesn't become reality through magic. It takes sweat, determination, and hard work. Our collective staff and board are united by a belief that we can fundamentally improve long-term economic well-being, not merely ensure their survival, building not a safety net, but a trampoline, ensuring that people can reach for greatness that exists within them. It takes more than setting minimal expectations for those that walk through our doors. It requires we take risk. It requires we push beyond what is required. It takes amplification of our services, the kind intended to ripple to the next generation and then the generation after that. It takes a partnership with our funders and policymakers to strengthen the systems that affect the poor, which most often do not presume greatness. And at times, they can be the very headwinds that people are facing. And for our communities, improved access to those resources that matter most, that all communities are structured fairly, that opportunities for quality education and financial stability can be achieved regardless of where you come from or what zip code you grew up in. In practical terms, it means not just helping 13,000 people find jobs, which we did this past year. It means, yeah. It means a push to add parenting education throughout all our services. We are set to reach over 10,000 children between the ages of 0 and 8. This will change lives. It means ensuring financial literacy also is integrated in helping every person we serve anywhere in any program to open and contribute to a savings account, because we know people who have savings accounts do better. It means advancing our vision of higher levels of education and training to improve economic outcomes. Next year, we will be expanding our education and training to include clean energy, technology, and a top secret virtual reality platform, which Dennis tells me I can't speak about. So, it means expanding Single Stop, a screening tool that drives resources to individuals working hard to find work or to stay in school. This past year, we combined with Civic Hall, the innovation of Andrew Rache. Civic Hall is a learning and collaborative platform. It's to advance technology and problem solving for the public good. It has reached thousands. Its mission is also to help those in underrepresented and underserved communities to get high-level training and well-paying technology jobs. Andrew is with us tonight, and he's joined by Civic Hall board member Jennifer Vento. Welcome. And this year, under Andrew's leadership, we hope to launch an innovative digital training center, a combined project that will leverage Apex, Paul Smith College, and Civic Hall. This 80,000 square foot digital training center will train over 3,000 students a year. In short, it means that we do more than what is asked of us, because we know it amplifies outcomes. Chris Patera, our corporate partner of the year, you certainly understand the concept of doing more than what's required. Ocean Janitorial, you built it from the ground up, and you've been paying it forward year after year through your generous contributions to Fedcap, and I thank you. Chris, there he is. Chris is joined tonight by so many corporate sponsors all around the room, and of course virtually. And I thank you all for standing with us as we strive to make a difference. In the Talmud, it says, every blade of grass has an angel bending over it, saying, grow, grow. And in closing, as I reflect on the past year and what is ahead, I'm reminded again that no one succeeds alone, and that at some point in our lives, we each have been that blade of grass, and at other times, the angel. Tonight, we're all angels, standing by one another. So thank you so much for joining us, and I hope you have a wonderful evening. I would like to turn it over to our MC for tonight, Lori Lutz. Lori's anxious to take the mic. She plans this down to the second. Before I turn it over, I do want to mention that Lori, who's been with Fedcap for all 12 years that I've been here, is retiring. She's going off to a new job, a grandmother, where she's been really most of her focus and attention is on her grandchild, and for good reason. She's adorable. But I've worked with Lori for over 30 years, and this is a big loss for me. In fact, I decided I wasn't capable of engaging in this discussion in front of all these people. I don't have it in me. Otherwise, I'll be blithering, and you don't want that. But we want to wish Lori the best and let her know what kind of impact she's had on this organization for the past 12 years. It will be a giant hole. And so please help me. Welcome. We all saved up to buy her a present, and then we thought, well, you know, we're not going to give it to her a present here. And so we gave her the thing that probably she really wanted most. So my guess is what she really wants most, rather than, you know, the briefcase, the watch, or a pair of earrings. Oh, my Lord.
Thank you. That was amazing. Thank you. Chris, it was so great to see you travel the world, visit the many places where Fedcap is amplifying its impact. By doing more than is required of us, by demonstrating that we never give up on anyone, we are changing lives for generations to come. Chris, your vision is inspirational, and I know I'm joined by our many colleagues and friends in saying thank you for what you do every single day and how hard you work to bring our vision to reality. Tonight, we too, just like Chris, will be visiting companies from across our global footprint. While we can't visit every company of the Fedcap Group, know that each is working so hard to make a difference. Each is bringing the power of possible to life. And so, without further ado, let's head to the United Kingdom. And here is Brian Bell, Chief Executive of Fedcap UK. Hi, Brian.
Hi, Lori. Good to see you again. Hope everything's going well there in the US, and a big hello to all of yous from your extended family here in the UK. We've 100 people in the room tonight, from as far north as Aberdeen to as far south as Brighton. We're in a town just outside of London called Redden, celebrating here tonight with you. The contracts we deliver in the UK are to support people who find themselves unemployed for whatever reason, and we're looking to support around about 100,000 people over the next 5 years.
Brian, that is so amazing. So how is Fedcap UK actually amplifying its impact?
So as I said, our primary objective is to find people sustainable work. But in doing that, we need to support people through a range of challenges that they face in their lives, from housing, from addictive behaviours, and of course, post-pandemic, a lot of people are coming forward with health conditions that they didn't have before. Some people are afraid to leave the house, and we need to work with those people and develop the right services. I spoke to Heather earlier today, and I think you'll find her story inspiring. Hi Heather, welcome to Fedcap, and thank you for coming in today. Go on, tell me a little bit about your life prior to coming to Fedcap Stord Scotland.
Before Fedcap, I'm 53 years old. I've been through Stord Scotland with yourselves from November last year. Before that, it was a topsy-turvy. It was I was quite isolated. I'd worked from home for 17 years. I suffer with anxiety and depression, which I got after my first son was stillborn. I kind of struggled on for a few years, and then one day just hit the front door and couldn't open it and walk out. But lockdown came and the self-employed went down the drain. My husband and my son lost their jobs. My youngest was started college. And it got really bad, to the point you learn a new level of humiliation. Food banks and sort of me and Simon not eating so the kids could and things. And that was when it was, I need to get a job. We cannot go on like this. And I'll be honest, at the beginning, I didn't really know a lot about who Stord Scotland were or what the whole process was. The way the team worked, I think because it was a team thing between sort of Ailey, Mark and Gary, they all gave me something that kept me going, that bolstered me, that helped me. And even down to things that really aren't their concern, like, you know, how to get in touch with food banks and things, and, you know, were we coping and how were the kids? And it seemed as though they were working so naturally and bringing me out without me even realizing it. And I think just almost as though they kind of surrounded you, kind of in a hug, if you like. And then I got the interview, and Ailey even, you know, phoned me one time, right, have you got something to wear, and talked me through it and calmed me down, and, you know, and they were very aware of it and helped me literally walk through the door for the interview. And it worked, and I know I was hard work for them because I don't believe in myself. I still don't see what people see. I don't think I ever will, but I officially became Diageo on the 25th of October. So that was me officially back into the workforce, and it's great. I genuinely feel as though I'm going to wake up one day and none of this has happened, because I don't believe I do it myself sometimes. Stord Scotland, it's as though they're investing in who you are as a person to get you where you need to be. And that's what they've done for me. They've got me where I needed to be for my family, for financial, but also without me realising it, for myself. You know, I actually smile a lot more now. So it's not just the job, it's a level of living that you're happy, not just existing.
Oh, Heather, thank you for coming in and sharing your story with us today. I found it utterly inspiring. Thank you.
Thank you for having me, really.
Brian and Heather, this is so powerful. Brian, it's clear that your team made a significant, significant difference in Heather's life. So now, let's see what is happening in New England.
Hi there. New York, all of us here at Community Work Services here in Boston are proud to be part of the Fedcap Group and so happy to be here celebrating the Power of Possible Gala Impact Amplified.
Hi, Lori. Hi, everyone. The state of Maine welcomes you.
Hi from New Hampshire.
Hello, Fedcap Group. Greetings from Rhode Island. Best wishes.
Hi, everyone. It's absolutely wonderful to see you all. And I think we're going to begin our conversation in New England by talking with Serena Powell, who's the Executive Director of Fedcap Inc. in Maine. Serena, what are you doing in Maine to amplify your impact?
Hi, Lori. Well, nearly 6 years ago, Fedcap was awarded a statewide contract to place people on public assistance in Maine into employment and to help them meet their educational goals. I'm so proud of the work that we've done over the last 6 years. We've helped 18,000 people take steps towards greater self-sufficiency. We've helped people get 11,000 jobs. Over the last year, our focus has been on immigrants and refugees in Maine, many of which experience language barriers, ensuring that they get the services that they need.
Wow, Serena, 11,000 jobs. And I can't think of anything more impactful than helping someone that's new to the country and new to the state actually find a job and be able to support their family. So who are some of the businesses that are helping you accomplish this goal?
Well, Lori, I have with me today Barb Shannon, Senior Director of Sales for Co-Work Staffing Services. They've made quite a difference here in employment for people in Maine. In the last year, Co-Works has helped us place 30 of our program participants in well-paying jobs in pharmaceutical manufacturing. And they recently gave us a check for $10,000 to help support the work that we do with them. So Barb, can you tell me why Co-Work Staffing Services is so committed to this work and helping immigrants in Maine get jobs?
So Co-Works' first priority, of course, is to work with our clients. That's how we make our money, and that's the important part of being in a business. And but what we need to do to supply our clients with what they need is to find a really reliable workforce. And the new immigrants, the new Mainers, the immigrants to the area, we've found have just been so dedicated and hardworking. They are here, they want to go to work, they are going to work long hours, and they're going to do what needs to be done to get the job done well for our clients. And it's their dedication that has really proven to Co-Works what a reliable and great workforce they are for us.
So in the last year or so, could you tell me what kind of jobs our program participants have been filling that you've assisted them with?
The jobs are predominantly in the manufacturing arena, so a lot of production positions, light assembly in a clean room, which means they're working with medical manufacturing. They're in food production. We have several clients that manufacture different types of food products like salsas and pizza dough, and they're able to go and do these jobs.
What do you think is the most effective part of the Fedcap Co-Works partnership?
What's been great about our partnership with Fedcap and Families Forward now is the fact that we can call and explain our need and that we really feel that we're listened to. People here really understand what we're trying to achieve and will ask the necessary questions so that we're moving forward.
Boy, thank you so much, Serena and Barb. Isn't that great? The Fedcap Co-Works partnership is really changing the face of Maine. So now let's head south a little bit to Massachusetts. Let's find out all that's happening in Mass. And with us is Craig Standing, Executive Director of Community Work Services in Boston. Hi, Craig. How are you amplifying the CWS impact?
Here in Boston at CWS, we are focused on building the kinds of partnerships across the city that result in a seamless, easily accessible network of supports for people in need. Our goal is to make it easier for people to get the supports they require when they need them, enabling them to be able to focus on employment and long-term economic well-being. Today, I'm honored to talk with Lauren Baker, the First Lady of the Commonwealth of Massachusetts. Lauren, you have such a gift for bringing organizations together. You actually introduced me to the Director of Horizons for Homeless Children. And because of that introduction, we are now serving breakfasts and lunches to all the preschool children at Horizons. This has allowed us to serve so many more children. and has increased the number of participants that we employ in our culinary program as well. And now we are actually talking to Horizons about bringing our job training program on site to the parents at Horizons. So Lauren, what has made you such a leader in building these kinds of interagency connections?
Well, I think I'm a connector kind of by nature, and I really think that it's important that all of these great organizations that we have who serve populations at risk, and in your case, social services, I think it's really important that we all work together, because that is what helps us expand our reach to people that need the service and to expand our resources and stretch our resources as far as we possibly can. So I think it is just incredible what you've done with Horizons, and it is just, it's a win-win-win for you, for Horizons, and especially for the families that you serve. You're feeding their children and training the parents. It doesn't get any better than that.
Thank you so much, Lauren.
And thank you, Craig and Lauren. This is remarkable. Standing together, sharing resources and expertise is exactly how our work gets amplified. You know, I can't think of anybody better on this planet than bringing people together to get things done than our friend Herb Sturz. Would you please join me in remembering Herb?
When I was a young kid, I rooted for the underdog. My baseball team was not the Yankees. It was the Giants when they weren't winning much. I just feel everyone needs a helping hand a little bit.
If you do research on some of the big issues of our time, the curtailment of stop and frisk, the decision to close Rikers Island, bail reform, you'll probably never see the name of Herb Sturz. But here's a guy who was self-taught in criminal justice, self-taught in urban planning, and was inconspicuous in working behind the scenes on some of the major issues of our time.
Herb, to me, is somebody who puts really good ideas and gets them done, where nobody else was able to do that. There are whole sections of the city that owe their health to the foresight, and that's Herb at his best, sort of looking down the road.
Justice is so paramount in all our lives in making society a better place, and people suffer so badly when they don't have justice, and they thrive when they have it.
His belief that people deserve a chance to succeed, independent of their past, independent of where or how they grew up, or even any mistakes they may have made. He's lived his life truly driving that message.
I remember when Wildcats started, before the dog cleanup law, and there was dog crap all over the streets of New York, and Herb's idea was he would give each Wildcat worker a wand, and they would zap it, and then somebody would come in behind, and they would use it as fertilizer and sell it. It was a pretty shitty idea.
By and large, you just keep at it. Persistence.
It is the old Churchill line of never give up, never, ever, ever give up, and that's Herb Sturz.
Oh, you're too kind, too kind. Well, good evening. I'm Gene Waddy, CEO of Alpha Business Solutions from Red Bank, New Jersey. So I came a little ways to be here tonight, but I'm glad to be here. I'm so impressed by the work of the Fedcap Group, and I'm delighted to be here tonight asking you for your support to allow them to do even more. In truthfulness, I only got to know the Fedcap Group in the past several years. In addition to becoming a steadfast donor, which I am a donor, that matters. You have to show up. Put your money where your mouth is, so I am proud to be a donor. I serve as the chairman of the board of one of its companies, the Wildcat Group, founded, as you heard earlier, by the extraordinary Herb Sturz. Thank you. I am dedicated to the mission of Wildcat in part for personal reasons. And I'm going to try to hold it together and not get emotional. But years ago, my sister, my baby sister, made some bad, bad decisions and ended up incarcerated. And I'm going to ask everybody, because this is very important to me, it's very personal. My sister, Karen, made some bad decisions some years ago, ended up incarcerated and separated from her family for many years. And it was a heavy blow for the family because I had no understanding of what the system could do to a person. And yeah, she made some bad decisions, as we all do in life, but she served her time. And she paid her debt to society. What I did not understand was, after she came out of prison, the punishment did not stop. The punishment was perpetual. Every time she went to get a job, denied, because of a background check. It doesn't matter what job it was. If she had a damn paper route, she couldn't lock down that job because she served time. So when you have a loved one in jail, that pain runs really deep. And you know, my sister Karen was lucky. She's watching tonight. Karen, listen, I love you. And I believe in you. And she takes after her big brother. Now she's an entrepreneur and she's got a little logistics business and she works with Amazon and she does the delivery service, like that last mile, you know, where they got to get the stuff from the warehouse to your house. My sister does that. And I'm proud of that. So I'm here to support my sister, but not just my sister, but support people out there that's suffering through the rigors of the system, what the system can do to you. Maybe they don't have the support structure that Karen had and has, but I'm here tonight to say that there's help, there's hope and there's help for people who want to turn it around, and it's not easy. So, as Christine said, we need to stand by one another. And that's why that's what I see Wildcat doing every day, standing by and standing up for those who need a second chance. I'm also intrigued by the concept of Impact Amplified, which is a fantastic tagline for tonight. It's about doing more than is expected of you and doing what's really needed, what's really impactful, and when it is needed. And it's a phenomenal, phenomenal vision. That's why I support the Fedcap Group. They never settle. And this is why we need you to dig deep. Let's see, this is where I'm gonna get into. Dig deep, get ready. Go in them pockets. All right, we're getting ready to get into it. All of you get out your credit cards. Everybody. And there are two ways you can give. First way, you can text to give. So just get out your phone and send a message to the number 50155, thank you, with the keyword amplify, your name and your donation amount. You'll receive an automated response with a link. Click on that and follow the instructions to complete your gift. It's just that simple. For those of you that are here at Cipriani's, the lucky ones, for all of you that are watching from home, listen, I get it. A lot of crazy stuff going on, but tonight, I wish you were here to see this beautiful venue and see New York be in New York. This is what it's all about, showing up. So. So for those of you that are here at the tables, you'll see sitting in the middle by your centerpiece, a little piece of machinery. You can dip your credit card right there, and the dip jars are set for $100 a dip. Multiple dipping is allowed, that's okay. But one dip equals $100. But don't worry, you can keep on dipping. Again, thank you for your generosity and your belief in our collective mission. Let the giving begin. Thank you.
Please welcome to the stage Mark O'Donohue, Chair, Fedcap Group Board of Directors.
Hi, everyone. I want to congratulate Christine and her team on another wonderful event. And of course, congratulations go to Lori Lutz, who is our master of ceremonies and has been the master of ceremonies of these events for many years. Like Chris, I can't really believe that we're losing Lori. I remember the first time I saw Chris and Lori in action, and I said, who are these women? But they're amazing. They're an amazing duo, and we're gonna miss Lori really deeply. So it's amazing to see how our impact and footprint have grown. I'm deeply proud of the fact that Fedcap is making a significant difference in hundreds of thousands of lives every single year. And I want in particular to thank the 118 board members of the 23 agencies of the Fedcap Group who generously volunteer their time and their talents to the organizations they serve. Their leadership allows Fedcap to leverage its resources to do whatever it takes to make and exceed our targets, whether it be the number of jobs, the number of people placed in jobs, the children who advance in their grades, children with disabilities, the young people going to college, and adults completing their education. And the important work of Fedcap would not be possible without our partners. Our partners consist of our supply chain, subcontractors, and community service partners. It's an amazing statistic, but I'm told that we have over 10,000 business and community partners across our footprint. The quality of our work is a direct reflection of the quality of your work, our partners. So I'd like every business partner and every community partner in the room to stand. Let's hear it for their commitment to our work. And that applause is for those of you who are streaming in as well. Now, as you've heard from Chris, one of our newest partners is Civic Hall. And the results of that partnership are simply amazing. Amazing because this is a project, when I first heard of it, I gave it less than a 10% chance of success. But through her work, the leadership of Andrew Roche and the other directors of Civic Hall, one of whom is with us tonight, Jen Vento. Thank you, Jen. And new partners, Apex, which joined us in the last year, Paul Smith College, which is joining us now. We stand to begin an amazing project in New York City, which will establish a technology training program for high-tech jobs, specifically to help New Yorkers struggling with barriers to employment, as well as those newly unemployed during the pandemic. So this is an example of what Chris calls the power of possible, and working together in a way that is truly inspiring. I would say that among our most important and certainly one of our more enduring and successful partnerships is its relationship with Ocean Janitorial Services, which we are honoring tonight as our Corporate Partner of the Year. Year in and year out, led by Chris Portera and his team, Ocean Janitorial has been a big part of Fedcap's success. Please join me in welcoming Steve Coons, the president of Fedcap Rehabilitation Services and one of the longest serving employees of the Fedcap Group, who will present this award.
Good evening, everyone. Hope everybody's having a great time. And to second Christine and Mark, I want to thank the venue, Cipriani's, for such a great and beautiful venue for tonight. It's a pleasure to be here. And obviously, we can say we're back. And we can also say we never left, especially throughout the 2021, throughout the pandemic. But tonight, I want to say good evening to everybody, and thank you once again for your full participation and support for coming out tonight. We have a great honor here tonight. I want to thank Mark for his great remarks. I also want to thank Christine for establishing the Corporate Partnership Award year in, year out. And I know we have many corporate sponsors, supporters, vendors in the room, and we thank you all. So round of applause to each of you. Thank you. So it's great to be here with you tonight, and I thank you all for your tremendous support of the Fedcap Group year after year, and 2021 has been quite the year. Our work is simply not possible without your generous participation and supports, and we mean that from the bottom of our hearts. Tonight, I'm especially pleased to present Chris Portera and his team of professionals at Ocean Janitorial Supply with the Corporate Partner of the Year Award for 2021. Well deserved, Chris. A little bit more about Ocean Janitorial. Ocean Janitorial has been working with Fedcap Rehabilitation Services for over 30 years. Can you imagine? Throughout these three decades, they have been tremendously generous in supporting our mission of employing people with disability in living wage jobs, workforce, and career development. Wow. They understand our mission and they believe in it. Like everybody in this room, they understand our mission and they believe in it. They are a true definition of a corporate partner. Furthermore, Ocean Janitorial is an industry leader, always staying on the cutting edge of new and innovative cleaning technologies, products, and services. They continue to provide extraordinary customer service and support. And throughout the pandemic, we couldn't have had a more trusted and valued business partner to assist us in performing our essential services to our important client base. And we thank you. We thank you. For us at Fedcap Rehabilitation Services, Ocean Janitorial has become the standard bearer for which all vendor support companies are evaluated. We are so fortunate to call Ocean Janitorial both our partner and our friend. Thank you, Chris. Yeah, thank you. So without further ado, please join me in welcoming Chris Portera, president of Ocean Janitorial Supply Company.
That's some speech. Thank you. Hello, everyone. Thank you. I really think I should shave more when we take the pictures. I noticed that.
We can fix that.
Yes, we can fix that. Too late. But I just want to say thanks to Fedcap. I think I've been a vendor for you guys for like 30 years,
yep.
Somewhere around there. And I think probably around year five, I got invited to walk around Fedcap and see what they were doing and see how they were training people and see how they were taking people who were on the street and getting them jobs and giving them lives. And that's when I kind of was all in after that, because it touched me and touched Ocean, everybody here that's been with me for a while and has done a lot of this stuff. It really made it more personal on a lot of levels, and hopefully over the last 30 years, you know, I've spent a lot of time in the buildings. I've seen a lot of the employees. And the one thing I can tell you is every time I go in and I talk to Fedcap employees, they're all happy. They're all smiling. They're all just love being at work. And I'm like, what's going on? I'm miserable. I'm working my ass off, and these people are all happy. And you know what? After a while, you realize that where they came from and what they have, they had a job. They had respect. They were able to pay their bills. And that's all I was trying to do. I mean, you know, for 30 years, three kids, you know, wife, everything going on. I'm trying to pay my bills and get ahead. So, you know, I just want to thank Fedcap, Steve, everybody about, you know, I think I've gotten more out of this than I could ever give to the Fedcap organization. Ever give to the Fedcap organization. You know, and I hope that, you know, one more thing I'm going to say is, I 32 years we're in business, something like that, 32 years. I'm getting to the end of my career. So I spent, you know, 30 years running around, just trying to survive. And now I'm getting up and I'm realizing this might be over soon for me working. And now I'm smiling. And I realize what all these Fedcap employees did over these years and why they were happy, it finally dawned on me. And I thank Fedcap for that, because it didn't happen after I retired. So every day I get up and go to work, I'm enjoying it now. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, join us in remembering Ken Harrison, founder Imprint Marketing and a longtime supporter of Fedcap.
Thank you, Mark, and thank you, Steve, and congratulations to Chris and the entire Ocean janitorial team. I hope you're having a great evening. Are you having a great evening? Yes. So let's continue our journey, and let's head north to Canada. And I would like to introduce Grant Collins, president of Fedcap Inc. and Fedcap Canada. Good evening, Grant.
Hi, Lori. Hi, Fedcap Group.
So, Grant, actually, what kind of work are we doing in Canada?
Here in Canada, we serve as the administrative lead of a very large network of providers. There's actually 41 providers, 57 locations in a geography that's about 1,600 square miles. What we do through them is improve the economic well-being of everyone that we serve, particularly those who have barriers to work. Our network provides sustainable, relevant impacts for all of the individuals, job seekers, and families that we serve.
Grant, that is just so exciting, and I imagine that being the lead of a network allows us to really make tangible, long-lasting change in the entire system.
Well, it's a new, what they call employment services transformation, and you're absolutely right, Lori. As a prototype, it means that we do a job in which the rest of the province will be learning from our experiences. Particularly what's happened now is we are serving more people in this program than ever before that come from a wide variety of what we call inclusion groups. So we're working with Indigenous, we're working with newcomers, we're working with Francophones, we're working with persons with disabilities in ways that really haven't up until now been done in Canada.
So Grant, what kind of supports are we offering to the network?
In fact, we have with us today Rachel Hunt, Senior Director of Employment Services for Amity Goodwill, one of our providers, who will talk a little bit more about that today.
HOP is a great resource that we've been able to utilize through Fedcap. Clients have been loving the Power of Possible workshops, and it's been very effective. They've been able to find jobs through it. So it's been a very fantastic tool that we've been able to utilize for our more highly barriered clients.
Big shout out to the Power of Possible people.
Another thing is through Fedcap Cares. There's a lot of tools in Fedcap Cares that have been very beneficial. An easy example for me is the email to text function.
Yes.
Communication with clients is a really difficult thing. It can be very difficult. So that's been a very helpful tool that we've been able to utilize, as well as some reporting functions.
Fantastic. Big shout out to the Fedcap Cares folks. What are some of the outcomes that the network has produced that you're most proud of?
Well, one of the outcomes that I'm very proud of is that out of all the employment that we've had so far while in the Fedcap model, almost 60% of those clients have been clients on social assistance. And that has changed from 23% before the Fedcap model. So that's been one thing that I'm very proud of, and I know the organization is really proud of.
That's excellent. And that's really big for Ontario, by the way. Thank you.
So thank you, Grant, and thank you, the Canada team. I want you to think for a moment about what Grant said, or about what Rachel said. She said that 60% of the individuals who they found jobs for were on social services. That meant that they didn't just need training and job placement. They might have needed housing. They might have needed behavioral health care, or child care. This makes the work that we're doing in Canada really remarkable. So congratulations to our Canada team. Finally, let's conclude our journey tonight by heading to Texas. And here is Todd Marvin, the president of Easter Seals Texas. Hi, Todd.
Hi, Lori. It is great to be with you and with everyone here in Texas and across the globe celebrating the Fedcap Group and the Power of Possible.
Woo! Todd, how is Easter Seals Texas amplifying its impact?
As you all know, Easter Seals Texas works with many children with disabilities, and we recently launched a new school for young adults with autism called the Greenleaf Neurodiversity Community Center. The center will offer services to assist young people with autism transition to adulthood, filling a critical service gap that is not being met at this time. The center is an example of an important partnership with Austin School District, and a large portion of the project has been funded through parents and local donors that are passionate about the work we are doing with people with autism in Central Texas.
Todd, this is absolutely inspiring. I want you to all imagine how much this center must provide relief for parents who struggle with their children graduating from high school and they're not yet ready to transition to independent adulthood, and their parents are simply uncertain about what to do and where to go. In fact, we have a conversation tonight with two parents whose sons go to the center. And the conversation occurred with Randy Shade, who is not only a board member of Easter Seals Texas, but she's also the chair of the Greenleaf Steering Committee. Hi, Randy.
Hi, Lori, and hello to everyone in the Fedcap Group. I am so pleased to be with y'all this evening from Austin, Texas, and I've got with me today Nydia Heston and her fabulous son, Quinn, and I can't wait to ask them a couple questions so that you can learn more about what we're doing here.
Great, thanks for having us.
Yeah, well, my first question is really simple, but really important, which is, what is it about this Greenleaf project at Easter Seals that inspired you to get involved?
Yeah, I think when I first heard about this back in 2016, it was just really amazing to me that there was a group of people who understood kind of the growing need for access for a community of people as they got older out of high school, or also to have that kind of safe community of peers. So that was really exciting to me to get involved. When I saw on Facebook that they were covering it, I immediately, you know, called and was like, how can we get involved? I think this is really great.
Well, we really appreciate your involvement. It's made a huge difference. And Quinn, what is it about the Greenleaf Project here at Easter Seals that made you want to get involved?
Well, I think it's that the people that are here understand people that are neurodiverse and understand that, hey, we sometimes need accommodations, and they provide that. And also, the activities are broad enough that they can bring in all these different people, but then in the actual clubs, we can precisely pinpoint what people want to do.
Great, that's awesome. I've got with me Renee Kraft and her son, Jackson Sutton, who is an amazingly talented young man. So, Renee, as a parent, what is it about this project that got you so committed to getting involved?
Well, when I first heard about Greenleaf, the Easter Seals project, I was so excited because the idea that my son would have a place to come that was about creative arts and was about visual arts and would allow him to explore careers and to learn about independent living in this kind of setting, I was just thrilled, because I can't tell you how many nights I worried that there was not going to be a place for Jackson after high school. There really are no options, not many options, and the fact that it's being created and built just as we need it is just heaven sent. I'm really excited for him. I'm excited for us.
And Jackson, you are an incredibly talented young man, and I'm really glad to have you here. But I guess my biggest question for you is, what is your favorite thing about the opportunity to be at Easter Seals Greenleaf Project?
I get to show off my creative skills and use it as a path for me to someday gain independence and possibly find a career. And I hope I can achieve what I need in life.
Randy, I'm in awe. You know, you realize that something like this center doesn't just happen. It happens because a group of people have a dream, and they hold on to that dream. And so I want to have a big shout out to Todd and to Randy and to Nadja and Quinn and Renee and Jackson and all of the people in the community who worked so hard to make that dream come true. Amen. Wow. What an extraordinary evening. Visiting places where the Fedcap Group is working to make a lasting impact in the lives of people who need us. Not just doing the minimum, but going over and above every single day. The work that we do together can be difficult, and it requires that we stand by one another, side by side, holding one another up when times are challenging, and celebrating together when times are good. We're so much better together, standing as one.
When the night has come and the land is dark and the moon is the only light we see, no, I won't be afraid. No, I won't be afraid. just as long as you said, stand by me. So darling, darling, stand by me. Oh, stand by me. Oh, stand by me. Stand by me. If the sky that we look upon should tumble and fall, and the mountain should crumble into the sea, I won't cry, I won't cry, no, I won't shed a tear, just as long as you stand, stand by me. So darling, darling, stand by me. Oh,
appreciate you being here. Have a good night, and of course, just be safe.